In this review, which has been recently published in Journal of Personalized Medicine, is an overview of minimal residual disease by next generation flow or by next generation sequencing applied to all clinical trials that were done so far. And a final point was made by us. Thinking at the possible utility in clinical outside clinical trial in clinical practice. So far, the recommendation is not to use minimal residual disease in clinical practice because there is not a large randomized trial that can support the utility of minimal residual disease measurement outside clinical trial. But it is obvious that minimal residual disease is really something that has to be measured and is something useful. And it's important to try to get to the point to have a measurement in our patient with multiple myeloma. It is important because to identify sustained complete remission patient with multiple myeloma can mean a longer survival for the patient. It is also important because we have a lot of novel agents and the power of the novel agent can be measured by the fact of achieving MRD negativity. So these, I think, are good points to evaluate minimal residual disease, either by next generation flow or by next generation sequencing.